lightning round of questions.
You go first. What song can you sing right now that is from a 90s hip hop group or rapper?
Regulators.
Do it. Regulator!
It was a black night. A clear white moon. Warren G was in the streets.
Trying to consume
some skirts from the heat so I can get some boat. Rolling in my ride, chilling all alone. Just
hit the east side of the LBC. On a mission trying to find Mr. Warren G.
Seen a car full of skirts, ain't no need to see. So you search good, what's up with
213. So I hooked the left on 21 and live with some brothers shooting dice. So I said, let's do this.
I jumped up the rap and said, what's up? Some brothers pulled some tricks, so
I said, I'm stuck.
Girls beeping me, I'm a riding
curb.
Looking so hard, I straight hit the curb. Making better things and some
horny tricks.
And none of the homies and the suckers
in this mix.
So I'm getting jacked.
I'm breaking myself. I can't believe they taking Warren's wealth. I took my rings. They took my Rolex.
I looked at the
brother said, damn, what's next?
All right, I'm going to stop.
Yeah.
I can keep going.
Lex Luth. Bloop, bloop.
Yeah, it's book time.
Woohoo! What's up, y'all?
So it's December 27th here in LA, which means it is the day that our book comes out and we are en route.
Yes. It also means that there is no winter because it's freaking sunny and everywhere else it's snowing.
But it's cold. It's still cold.
It's cold. You gotta wear a jacket at least.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just got off of a few podcasts today.
We've been working, hustling.
Really awesome and beautiful. And you know what's interesting is new stuff comes up, you know, depending on the podcaster and like how they roll. Why did we write this book, baby? What's under it? Let's just say for you. Don't even answer for me. Don't answer for me, woman.
Okay. Well, I wrote this book with you.
That's me.
Because, quite honestly, like, I love books. I've been reading books since I was a kid, and especially books on personal development and spirituality and human performance and all of that. And I recognize that books are truly a portal that can change everything. You know, like, you are literally getting 3 hours of time with these authors, and you're getting their juiciest, best stuff because they're putting their best stuff into their work. So for me, books have been a way to have mentorship from the people that I really look up to and respect. And I'm excited because you and I have done a ton of work and we've studied with a lot of amazing people from all over the world. And I'm excited to bring what we've distilled down into our five principles that have truly supported us. Like, these are tools that we didn't just like know and then like, we use them all the time.
Yeah, this isn't just theory. Like, we literally sit in this in the shower today. We started a conversation about conscious and unconscious agreements.
We did.
Around relationships, because both of us have the same agreement around it, but some people in relationships don't have the same conscious agreements, and we for sure have a bunch of stuff that don't necessarily match completely. They're not like lock and key, but they're in the ballpark. Guys, we
for
just
those of you that know me know that I'm getting ready.
Yeah, she's addicted
for myself.
Addicted to lip gloss
and chapstick
or whatever you want to call it. We're about to head in, guys. This is freaking exciting. This is really exciting.
That's my excited face.
Exactly. I'm going to take this little guy off.
Okay.
Are you guys ready for this?
I don't think y'all ready for this.
This is this book. If you so choose to even take on one of the principles in it, will change your life forever.
Seriously. Like, literally, if you just do one of them, you'll be like, this is the best year of my life. This is insane.
Potentially. I mean, seriously, everything that's in that book.
No, if you really take it on, just one step, you'll say that.
Yeah, for sure.
100%.
We wrote it in Bali and in Morocco on our honeymoon.
So there's lots of love in there.
Yeah, there's all kind of love
there's
in Bali.
There's love and exotic awesomeness in there.
Yeah, exotic.
Your car?
Yeah, it's off. Okay. You know, funny thing about Priuses. Priusi. Where's my key? Here, you take this. Talk to these people, baby.
Hi. Priusi. What would the plural version of Prius be? Priuses. That sounds weird. Okay, we're going in.
Yeah, we are.
Lock and load.
Now or never.
Here, you hold.
Now or never.
I don't like holding selfies.
She doesn't like holding them. She thinks
feel very
that
pretentious.
It's exactly. You see? That's an unconscious agreement.
It is around pretentiousness and selfies.
A But it's not pretentious. We're just taking in
the Barnes of Nobles.
Barnes and Nobles, we love you. Amazon, we love you.
We do.
Simon & Schuster, we love you. Thank you guys for supporting us and holding
Chapters in Toronto, we love you.
Yes. Any other bookstore.
Any bookstore.
First of all, yeah, because bookstores
seriously.
Are almost dead.
And, like, and that makes us very sad.
We love bookstores. If you love bookstores, leave a comment below and tell us why.
Tell us which your favorite bookstore is.
Yeah, what was the book
and
that
what
changed?
Aisle,
yeah.
What section would you be found in?
Yeah, what changed everything?
Okay, here we go.
Alright, guys. I'm gonna let Alexi go first.
Alright, where would I be looking?
You would be looking for your name.
Yeah.
And it would be in the happiness.
There's me.
There's me. Down there at the bottom.
Oh.
There's only one copy left. What? Yeah.
Oops. We have to buy
awesome.
It.
We have
gonna
to.
Leave it for someone or should we write?
I think we leave it for someone.
Okay.
And then we talk to this young lady over here. No. She doesn't work here.
She's
I thought she worked. We need to find out if they're ordering more.
Then you have a question.
It's her. We have a book, and it's called Now or Never. It's amazing.
So for any of you who don't know about this, if you buy the book, audio, Kindle, regular version, go on to nowornevertheBook.com.
Yes.
And you get a free 5-week training with us.
Yes.
That's live.
It starts January 2nd, so you better get on it. ASAP.
All right, so we just picked up our book. It's pretty exciting. You know what's interesting I find, Preston?
What?
Is... this is now our second book in Barnes & Noble.
Uh-huh.
And what's crazy is this, like walking into a Barnes & Noble and seeing your book, this was a big dream for me. You know, I always wanted to be an author and always wanted to write a bunch of books. And today is one of those days where it's like, this is the thing that was on our vision board.
Yep.
Like however many years ago, this is the thing that was on our New Year's resolutions and goals list however many years ago. And it's really interesting to be in the middle of it and to just take a moment and acknowledge that, because I think so often we get to the top of the mountain and we forget that we set out to climb that mountain 5 years ago or
yes.
10 years ago or 3 years ago.
Yes.
And
we are living the dream right now.
We're in it. Like we're living the dream, the moment, and it's pretty awesome.
Yeah. To be among such amazing authors as well, the people we grew up, you know, reading and studying, and to have, you know, I won't say that everything in our book is new, but a new way to share that from the perspective of, you know, what people are dealing with and being with now, that's fantastic. That just warms my heart. Let me ask you this. If there was one of the five steps, which one or which two would you say are the most important?
That's hard because they truly are all kind of necessary and they all play with each other. But I would say the first one,
which is
you always have a choice,
which
is the bridge to awareness. So building your awareness, because if you don't have awareness about how you're showing up, then you can't do anything about it.
Absolutely.
So the awareness is really where everything changes, because then you can do something about how you're showing up. So I would say that's super important. And then I would say, I'll kind of spin this question and make it my own for a second. The step that is most important for me and has been the most important for me since I've built the awareness and the responsibility and the action is owning who I am, which is step four, because I think for so long I did all the right stuff and I had the awareness and I had the mindset and I had the training and I had the responsibility and I had the action, but I was doing it kind of still on society's terms and doing it for society's approval, and it still felt off. And I think a lot of people in the work who do a lot of personal development and transformation work, they experience that. They're like, dude, I'm doing all the right stuff. Like, why am I still not feeling good or feeling in alignment? It's because we're not doing it from the space of owning who we truly are.
Yes,
so.
Yes. So, 2016, top three moments in our relationship.
Ooh, in our relationship. Getting specific.
Yep.
Okay, top three moments in our relationship. Our marriage. For one.
Getting married.
Getting married was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I actually didn't think, not that I didn't think I would enjoy getting married, but I was never one of those people that's like, I can't wait to get married.
Mm-hmm.
I was never that. So, being in the space of a beautiful wedding with our amazing community and family.
Yeah.
Was really awesome. I was shocked at how much I loved it.
Yeah.
Like, I was in such a good mood all day. I'm like, this is great, you know?
Yeah, it was pretty awesome.
It was great.
You know what was awesome about that?
What?
Delegation.
Yeah, guys, I delegated to my homegirls, and, like, they hooked it up.
The surrender, the let go.
And I'm the person that,
pass
like,
off.
Plans everything and, like, does all the travel planning and does all the planning of this and that. Da, da, da. So for me, I did what I did leading up to it. And then day of, I was like, you're going to do this. You're going to do that. You're going to do that. And my girlfriends were like, whatever you need. And they were so amazing.
It was beautiful.
Like, from setting up the hors d'oeuvres, because we did everything ourselves.
Yes. Let me ask you this, though, before we get off track.
Yeah.
What about getting married was your favorite moment? Like, what part, what moment, what section, what, like... thought came up where you're like, whoa, we just got married. This is awesome. I love this dude. He's pretty freaking sexy. Like,
yeah.
Where was that?
Yeah. I think for me it was the moment I first saw you.
Mm.
Like, when I turned the corner and I saw you, and like we locked eyes the entire time.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
We did not stop looking at each other the entire time throughout the ceremony, and it was really cool. To be in this like love vortex, and I felt everyone else's love around us. And I think for me, the coolest part was just like, it was just a knowing. It was like a yep, here we are, and this is happening because it was written.
Yeah.
You know, and like, it just felt that way. It felt so just of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. What about you?
Top three moments as a couple, 2016.
Yeah.
I'm gonna start there.
Okay.
It was. Blah, blah, blah. Mm. It was our dance.
Mm.
Like, our first dance as a couple. I felt like time stopped. It was only you and I there.
Mm-hmm.
And, I was just really present. And we were surrounded by, and guys, you know,
so
I know you guys, some of you guys think this stuff is woo-woo, but energetically, like scientifically, we are energy.
Yeah.
And the heart emits a bigger frequency than the brain does.
Mm-hmm.
And so imagine 250 hearts all vibrating and beating at the same people. They were all sending energy at us at the same time, which is just love being poured at us.
It was so good.
And we were, what was the song, the John Legend song?
All of Me.
Because all of me loves all of you. Love your
curves
and all your
things.
Imperfections. Give me your
baby.
Yeah, yeah. So that song is playing. We're on cloud 100, and it's just so good. And I was just super present to you. That's
it.
I got your top one, or your one.
My one.
What was two for you?
Second relational highlight, I would say. Ooh.
Oh.
Oh.
I like the sound of that.
Leading the Bridge Experience workshop with you.
Yes. Why are you still in all of mine?
In New Zealand.
Same.
Well, because here's why. Because that was our first international, like, big time workshop. We had done that workshop in the States, and we had done a few others in the States. But to do it on international soil and to do it with you and to be in such a state of flow, like,
we were
in the pocket.
Yes. If you guys are in Australia, like, make sure you get to our Bridge Experience. It's
bridgeexperience.com.
We're gonna be in Perth, Adelaide, Melbourne, Sydney, Auckland, New Zealand,
Gold Coast. Yeah. So yeah, that's my number two.
Okay.
And then what's your number two?
Yeah.
Sorry.
See, yeah, she did me. What's your number three then? Since you still, this is what happens. This is what I call being wifed. because she gets to go first, and then I get to make up a new answer.
You asked me to go first.
No, I did.
So it's not a get to go first.
She wifed me.
You asked me to go first. Okay, my third, yes. Since you asked.
Look, she's going to steal my third, too.
Since you asked. My third, I would say, is... and this is a recent one, is seeing you with my nephew, Simon. Because he's so cute. Hmm. And my nephew, Logan, as well. But they're brothers. But seeing you with, like, little baby Simon and how much, like, he became your little homie and how much you loved him, I thought that was really sweet. Aww. It was kind of like a foreshadowing into the future.
We're going there. Where's it at?
Where's what? A family. Uh-huh. Babies. Oh. That was cute.
Beautiful. Thank you. I didn't know that. So you guys learned it when I learned it.
See, I surprised him. I can still surprise him.
You can.
You can still get wifed and be surprised.
Yes, you can. So my second one would be, since you expressed the one that would have been my second one, this is a close second.
Okay.
Burning Man.
Oh, Burning Man is always so good.
At Burning Man... the last night when we found the Danstronaut truck.
So good.
And
that was like a highlight of my life.
Yes, we went primal. Like, guys, it wasn't just regular dancing. No. This was the type of dancing that, like, literally, like, we called our ancestors. Like, yeah. This was like pure beingness dancing. We were dancing like our lives depended on it, and it was so fun.
It was so fun.
And Alexi and I, for those of you guys who've never seen us dance together, when we get going, like, we're like John Travolta and like some other person in, no, we're like, what's the movie where he lifts her up and it's Patrick Swayze?
Dirty Dancing, that's one of my favorites.
We are like Dirty Dancing.
We're not like Dirty Dancing though. Like,
not that kind of dancing.
We don't do that kind of dancing.
But when they got in the groove.
We're like in the groove, like Dirty Dancing.
Yeah, yeah.
We're like more of those dance movies, dancing.
Yeah. Save the Last Dance.
We are like, we love dancing to like 80s and 70s and... really good, like,
yeah, Michael Jackson, or just like ridiculous house beats that are just like make you
like
get
super heavy, yeah. And yeah, it was good. Okay, so number three, that's a good number two.
That was number two.
I like that number two.
Number three, wow, we have been, oh, boom, got it. Our honeymoon.
I know, I was gonna say that, but I saved that for you.
In the desert.
That was so good.
On these camels in the middle of the Sahara Desert.
Yeah.
Like, everywhere we looked, in every direction, it was sand dunes. And
that was pretty magical.
That was like, just like, what? Like, yeah. Who gets to experience something like this? It just like was outside of what my brain could even like cognize until I was there in it with Alexi and like just, you know, having that time to do something so epic with the person that I love, my best friend, like that was just,
yeah, that
blew
was
me
awesome.
Away. Blew me away.
All right, one final question before we turn this thing off. What has been your greatest lesson from 2016?
Ooh, greatest L boogie, huh?
Yep.
That's an interesting one. I want to turn right here, but I'm not supposed to, so. I want to give him the signal. Can you give him the signal that I want to do that?
Put my hand out.
Put your hand out.
Doing the, I got this signal.
Got it.
My friend Fry.
There we go. biggest lesson 2016. There's Seal.
Oh, yeah. There's Seal.
The singer.
I thought he was saying there's someone that looks like Seal, but no, that's actually Seal.
No, that's the singer, Seal.
Welcome to LA.
Yeah. So... for me, the biggest lesson would be that every time that I position myself where it appears like I'm risking it all, mm-hmm. I also position myself to gain it all. And there's been quite a few times in 2016 where I was afraid, where the fear popped up. Am I good enough? Am I smart enough? Am I strong enough? Can I actually handle this? Can I hold this? And yeah. I pushed past that fear and stepped into it. And every single time I did that, something amazing happened. Even when it looked like I failed.
Hmm. I love that. Okay, cool. So when you fear, to sum it up, when you fear that maybe you can't handle the newness that you're stepping into, trust.
Yeah.
And trust that it'll turn out exactly as it needs.
Absolutely.
That's a great lesson. I definitely had a bit of that myself this year. I would say my big lesson besides that is what extraordinary focus can achieve. Because I'm someone who loves to create and loves to build a lot of stuff and do a lot of things.
Come on, guys.
I think that my biggest lesson is really focusing on what brings me the highest joy in my work, what brings also the highest contribution and service in my work, and what is the highest and best use of my gifts. And I think bringing that into 2017, like that, like hardcore focus and really like doing things right the first time so that I don't have to backtrack and figure it out later.
That's a big one.
Because, you know, you and I haphazardly got into this business. We weren't trying to get into this business. We were just trying to share what was on our hearts.
Yeah.
And this happened, which is great. But because of that, we didn't go about it in a very systematic way in building a business. So now this past year, really the last couple months, we've been circling back and reverse engineering our business and figuring out how to create systems around it that actually work as a company, as a business, versus just this cool idea and this cool thing that we get to do.
Well, yeah. It's a business.
No, for sure. But I'm saying we didn't come into it as we're going to start this business.
Yeah.
Here's our business plan. Here's the structure. Here's our email automation system. We were kind of like building something as we went and putting duct tape on along as we went.
Yes. So, duct tape.
Yeah, like, oh, let's just duct tape that.
Why do
that.
They call it duct tape?
Duct.
Oh, like a like
duct.
For
it's not
a
like
duck.
Duck quack quack.
Got it.
It's duct.
You learn something new every
like,
day.
Like, I think for like ducts.
Yeah, like air ducts.
Exactly.
Yeah. I get it. Ventilation systems.
Ventilation ducts.
Yes, okay, I get it now.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do a lightning round.
Okay. Lightning round.
Okay.
What is something that you're like a fear or a phobia that you have? Not like a philosophical fear, but a fear or a phobia that you have.
Heights.
Heights. I knew that.
Yes.
But tell me why.
I'm not quite sure, but it definitely shows up for me. We were in a bat cave, a gigantic window cave in Puerto Rico.
Cave of Ancana.
Yeah, and there was freaking guano and like bat juice. And then if you slipped on that guano, you were going to slide right out of that cave.
Thousands
and
of feet.
Die easily.
Into a jungle.
And Alexi's awesome. Like at the edge, you know, taking pictures and looking over the edge. And I'm like 19 feet back, like, yo, don't do that.
He's like, you're too close.
You're
I'm
too
like,
close.
I'm not too close. I still have 5 feet before I hit the ledge. I'm perfectly fine.
No. So yeah, me and those things don't work. What do you love the most physically about yourself?
The first thing that comes to mind are my feet.
Your ugly ass feet.
I love my feet. I think I have the cutest feet in the world.
Your feet are terrible. They're like little Miss Piggy feet.
They're
that
not.
She thinks are the greatest
I used to be
thing.
A foot model, okay?
That, yeah.
Seriously, I used to model for Birkenstocks back in the day. So, my feet are society approved.
No, they're not.
As cute.
They're like little Greek, German, fat
They're
feet.
Awesome. So, I would say my feet,
mm-hmm.
and then I would say my smile.
Is that right? You gonna hit them right after? Okay. I like it. I dig it.
And what's funny is I used to hate, like, my crooked teeth at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And I always wanted to get them fixed and, like, you know, because they always bothered me. I kind of have, like, a little snaggle tooth on one side.
Snags.
Snags. Got that snags. But the cool thing is as I've come to like really accept and love myself and mm-hmm. embrace myself, it's a part of me. Like, it's a part of what makes my smile so different.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not like, you see people who have had braces yeah. and Invisalign, they have like the perfect toothy smile.
Yeah, they look kind of weird sometimes.
Sometimes. And sometimes it's like, it's the same, like, it's like when people get plastic surgery, they look kind of the same.
Yeah.
Like the same face.
Yeah.
And it's like the same teeth. I have this like hyper unique smile with like that dimple that's just freaking awesome.
Yeah. So, that dimple that's just that, freaking that dimple. Awesome.
I only got one dimp.
Yeah.
So it's dimp. Not even a full dimple.
Patrick Dimp.
Just a dimp. Just that dimp.
The dimp song.
Like a dimp. All right. So what's your favorite physical trait about yourself?
I'd have to say, and this is an interesting one. It is my smile. It's my smile because I hated my smile for so long. I had really big lips as a kid. I guess people would still say I do, but as a kid, I had, my head was this size at 9 and my lips were even bigger. And so when I would smile, I still do. When I smile, I get lines everywhere. And somebody made fun of me about it and said like I'm all lips or something like that when I was like a kid, and I purposely stopped smiling. Especially in pictures and stuff like that. I love my smile. I think it's huge. I think it's great. I think it lights up the room when I'm lit up. And, yeah, that and, you know, my man John. No, I'm just playing.
Okay, lightning round. What is the one thing you really look forward to about getting older?
Ooh, teaching my kids and grandkids how to surf.
Just your kids or my kids too?
Just mine. Just mine.
Just checking.
Yeah. Okay. They all meet. Yeah.
First, I'm not gonna carry them or push them out or anything. It's
yeah,
just,
no. Okay. I got them.
Just perfect. Okay.
Yeah. yeah. So teaching our kids how to surf and just have fun, like just playing. You know, one of my favorite things, and Alexi is alluding to this a little bit ago about her nephew, but like we played tag and hide and go seek the other day.
So fun.
And I could have done that for 3 hours. Like, it was super fun. And we were just screaming and chasing each other. And he was freezing me like Iron Man. Unfreeze me, Logan. Like that. Those aren't even my kids. And I loved it.
Yeah, it was super fun.
Let those be our kids.
Like, yeah. Next level, man.
Yep. It's going to be a bunch of big-ass kids playing.
Yes.
With trampolines and skateboards. And just get outside. That's, yeah, I'm excited about that. And... what wisdom unfolds. That was Hulk Hogan. That's two.
Really?
Yes. That was Hulk Hogan.
We are just on a celebrity spotting mission.
We
today.
Are. And I don't care about him.
Me either.
No.
Wait, okay, yeah. I was like, he's the wrestler. One.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Incredible Hulk.
Yeah.
What about you? Getting old.
Getting old. Durr. I look forward to so much. Definitely like kids and family.
Mm.
And to see how that evolves and like having these little people walk around
mm-hmm.
that are a they, part of us.
And then they become like big people.
And then they become big people.
And then they hate you.
Who hate us eventually. Yeah. Looking forward to that as well. It's all a part of it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to, you know what's weird? You know how some people hate getting older? I actually love getting older. I feel like I get better with age because I, one, care way less. Yeah, we should stop and get our packages. I, one, care way less about what people think with every year.
Yep.
And two, I recognize that I have this, like, deepening of everything I've learned. Like, the stuff I learned a year ago that I thought I knew, this year I know on such a deeper level. And like the stuff I know now is going to only get deeper and deeper and deeper.
Okay.
We're getting yelled at by the parking peeps. So I'm looking forward to deepening my wisdom in a lot of ways. All right, I'm going to go and get our package.
Do it. We love you guys. Blessings and blessings.
Guys, if you're looking for a really great read for the new year, now or never, pick it up. Support some awesome peeps. We love you. I'm going to pick up packages.
Yeah.
Bye.
Get it. Get her done.